Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, December 22nd. The quick spread of the Omicron COVID variant has brought another reckoning about whether in-person school is really worth the risk in New Jersey and beyond. The state is reporting over 300 linked outbreaks in New Jersey schools, affecting thousands of students and thousands more who've had to quarantine. A number of K-12 schools have moved part, if not all, of school buildings back to remote learning and will have decisions to make after the winter break about how they'll handle in-person learning in the new year. It is possible, with a growing number of cases and outbreaks in the Garden State, that we may see a return to much of what we saw in 2020 when schools were all remote. Governor Phil Murphy on Tuesday reiterated his support for keeping kids in classrooms, pointing to a new test and stay policy that would allow students who were exposed to an infected person to remain in class as long as they were asymptomatic and tested negative before coming to school. We have more about that policy at nj1015.com. Higher education also being impacted by COVID outbreaks in the Garden State, and more New Jersey colleges will start the new year remote. The College of New Jersey at least until January 21st, although school officials did tell the student body they expect the spring semester to start in person on January 24th. The Marine Academy of Science and Technology in Monmouth County has also announced that they're moving to all virtual learning. That is effective already this week. Hospitalizations for COVID in New Jersey have now passed 2,000, the highest they have been in almost a year. Hundreds are in intensive care, 186 now on ventilators. Just a fraction of people being infected by this latest wave are ending up in the hospital, and we have no way of knowing how many of them have underlying health conditions. The state health department doesn't report that data. But the increase in occupied beds is starting to strain capacity in some areas of the state. Health officials expect hospitalizations will rise above 3,500 by the time we reach mid-January. More of you have been telling us you're thinking about testing yourself and others before holiday gatherings, for Christmas, for New Year's, but good luck finding a home test. They have been growing scarce. Walgreens announcing that they will limit sales to 4 per customer. Walgreens and other pharmacy chains are working with suppliers to increase inventory. At nj1015.com, we have a list of your best bets to try and find these home test kits and where they may still be in stock. If you have a teen with a driver's permit or a learner's permit, do you know that they are not allowed to drive alone back and forth to school? It had become such a problem in one New Jersey town that police put out an alert on social media. This was happening in Ridgewood after stopping several teens, finding out that solo permit driving was being allowed by a number of households. They said, "We cannot stress enough how unsafe and illegal this is. Under state law, allowing a minor with just a learner's permit to drive alone without a supervising adult leaves them open to permit suspension, a delay in getting a license, and worse, out-of-pocket debt or criminal charges stemming from any accidents or crashes." You can't really see a face in these video grabs, but police are hoping someone can identify images of this man caught on video drawing swastikas in front of a temple in West Orange on Saturday. The grainy images do show a person fleeing the scene. The motorcycle is red. You can see he's wearing a helmet. A jogger discovered the hateful graffiti on Saturday morning. If you think you might know who this is, you can contact West Orange Police by giving them a call or even on their Facebook page. The state population in the Garden State is shrinking, and a number of factors are here. Certainly, there is a good amount of out-migration, but experts with the Census Bureau say population loss can at least partly be attributed to deaths from COVID complications. State population as of the 1st of July estimated to be just over 9.26 million. That is down from over 12.6 million in the middle of 2020. What are some of the other factors involved here? Our Mike Simons has a full analysis at nj1015.com. Not even Christmas yet, but are you thinking about what you're going to do with your real tree when it's time to take it down? Don't just put it at the curb. You can recycle it. The American Littoral Society protects areas along New Jersey's shore, and they're in desperate need of old Christmas trees. They're used to rebuild sand dunes and protect salt marshes. How you can recycle it at nj1015.com. And have you seen this house yet? It's in Manalapan, and people have literally been lining up around the block and beyond just to get a look at all of the lights and decorations. Our Steve Trevelise is taking you on a photo tour of this amazing home this morning. Again, that's also at nj1015.com. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Wednesday, December 22nd. Have a great day.